June 2017, Apple updated both the 27-inch and the 21.5-inch iMac. We've already told you how impressed we are by the 27-inch, and now it's the turn of the 21.5-inch model. The iMac is still as gorgeous and thin as it was when Apple last changed the design in 2012, but a few things have changed around the back. Apple's added Thunderbolt 3 ports, which double up as USB Type-C, aka USB 3.1 ports. So you'll be able to get much faster transfer speeds when you plug in your new camera, external drives and so on. But it's what's on the inside that counts though, and Apple has made some significant changes there. In the case of the smaller iMac, the update is much more significant because it's jumped two processor generations to get the Kaby Lake chip. The other big news is that Apple has extended the range of 21.5-inch iMacs offering the Retina display. Now only the entry-level model doesn't offer Retina. And if you look at the two side by side, you can really see the difference, although it's probably less pronounced in this video. The Retina display is brighter, crisper, and you can see more colours. It's altogether a better experience. Given that you'd only have to pay £200 more to get a Retina screen and other enhancements, it's really a no-brainer that you'd opt for the Retina iMac. But that's not to say that the entry-level model is to be ignored. It's in a different league to the previous generation entry level, and if you don't need a Retina display, and if you've never looked at one, you won't know any better. It's a reasonably good dual processor. The entry level iMac is always dual core where the others are quad core. In our test we found the 2017 iMac's 2.3 GHz processor scored 66% more than the previous generation's 1.6 processor did. You'd expect that with such a giant leap in gigahertz. The point here is that Apple has made an entry-level iMac that's actually worth buying this time round. A more useful comparison to show the impact of the new Kaby Lake chip would be to look at the 3.1 GHz processor in the previous generation, 21.5-inch, and the 3.4 GHz processor in this generation's 21.5. Of course, you'd expect a boost given that we are comparing 3.1 to 3.4. Unfortunately, these are the only models we've tested, but the difference is still 16%. Aside from the display, the other major difference between these two iMacs is the graphics card. The entry-level model has an Intel integrated card, but if you want to do slightly more graphically intensive things like play computer games or edit videos and photography, then the discrete graphics in the Retina model will be more suited to your needs. In our test, the discrete card made a huge difference. For example, the max frame rate on the entry-level iMac was 10 frames per second, while the 3.4 GHz 21.5-inch managed 28 frames per second. It's also worth noting that the Fusion Drive is now a standard option on most iMacs, with only the entry-level models coming with a standard hard drive. If you opt for a Fusion Drive, it's a £90 build-to-order option, but brings with it a small SSD in addition to the larger hard drive. The flash component speeds things up for you because most of the things you need on a day-to-day basis are stored in flash memory. The most notable difference is the way your Mac starts up almost instantly. In one test we timed how long it took a 4GB file to be copied. In the case of the standard hard drive, this was just over 78 seconds, while the 3.4 GHz 21.5-inch model with its Fusion Drive took about 66 seconds. The bigger difference came when we compared the 3.4 GHz 21.5-inch to the 27-inch model with the same processor. Then the 27-inch copied the file in just over 37 seconds. A slightly more accurate test is the AJE Systems test, and here are the scores for that. So there's obviously more of a difference between the 27 and the 21-inch models here than meets the eye. We'd always recommend getting the Fusion Drive. We're impressed by the new 21.5-inch iMac, although we'd always recommend spending a little bit more to get the Retina display. The entry-level model is no longer crippled like its predecessor, and it's a decent machine. The differences between the 3.4 GHz 21.5 and the 27-inch models are significant, but the price difference here is £300. So we'd say that the 3.4 GHz model is still a good deal for your money, but we'd be inclined to recommend the 27-inch model over it if you can afford to pay the extra £300 for the bigger and better screen. We'll be right back.